Showtime! Good afternoon, everybody. We are back in the writing room in Nashville, Tennessee, in lovely Green Hills, where we are preparing to go to the recording studio tomorrow in East Nashville and start a new Mary Gauthier record.
Yes!
God, I haven't made a new record of my songs in quite a while. My last recording was released in 2018, and it was a collection of songs I had co-written with women and men who served in the military through the program Songwriting with Soldiers. So the Mary Gauthier record that came out before that was Trouble in Love, but I don't have any idea the date. I reckon it was 2014, maybe 15, I don't know. Somebody on the feed might know, or Google it.
Don't you think that we would, like, I would, do you think we would lose in a Mary Gauthier trivia contest?
I would lose, definitely, in a Mary Gauthier trivia contest. You know why? I don't look back.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
I don't look back. I habitually look forward, yeah. And I only look back in therapy. And I only look back when my life is falling apart and I need to self-reflect as to what it is I may be doing to cause it.
I just remember when I did that show with Betty, Sue, and Bonnie, and we put trivia questions together, and I realized I got almost all of them wrong for my own trivia. It was like...
Do you look back?
That's illuminating.
I don't look back.
I think I look back more than you do.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because I, you know...
I don't know. Trouble in Love. Thank you, Meta Jetta.
2014.
So it's been 8 years. Is that the right math? Almost 8 years.
Math time.
So if it was 2014, the last record I put out of my songs, it'll be 8 years. It'll come out in June of 2022. So we record next week and we release in June. Why so long, you might ask? Well... It takes a week to make a record. It takes 9 months to release one because vinyl manufacturing plants are backlogged. And the label that we do business with really feels as though it would be unfair to release a record without giving it the full Monty. And people enjoy vinyl now. So we schedule the release based on the availability of the vinyl manufacturing plant. And so there's some trivia for you. Although it seems like a while till June, it's not. In release terms, we got to make CDs. I got to figure out the artwork. I got to do the thing I dread the most, which is take pictures. Oh, God, I hate the camera so much. You know who else hates the camera? Lucinda. Lou
really?
Hates the photos. To get a good picture of her is hard. She does not like being in front of the camera. I do not like being in front of the camera. But we have some good friends now that we can kind of lean into. I thought Laura Schneider did great photos of you and I together.
Totally, yeah.
Yeah, so maybe we can get good pictures. So anyway, today's show, welcome everybody. It is Sunday, December 5th, 2021. 2021 is headed for... the rearview mirror really quickly. There's only 3 weeks left of it. Four weeks left of 2021, ish, and we'll be in 2022. I am excited to be with you today. We're going to play songs that you might not have heard yet because I've never played them in front of human beings before, including Jamie.
Including me, I was realizing as I heard you practicing, I went,
I got up really early this morning. I got up at 5 o'clock, and, you know I fell asleep with that headache
six. Yeah.
I had a migraine yesterday, and I passed out with it till about 9:30, and then my darling Jamie showed up with food, and... I take Trexamet when I get a bad migraine, and it had done its thing, so the migraine was lifting, and had some dinner, and went back to sleep by 11. So, you know, 5 this morning, I'm up tightening up songs and printing out lyric sheets and messing with guitar tunings and preparing. So, anyway, that's what I'm up to. We went to Key West for 7 or 8 days. We wound our way down there through a series of shows in Florida, which included some very proper and really lovely theaters. The Broward Center for the Performing Arts, the Stratz Theater. In Lauderdale, we played a beautiful community theater in Sarasota. We have worked our way back up through Eddie's Attic in Atlanta. We drove down, and the drive is intense. Driving in Miami is like being at war. It is a battlefield. Yeah. They pass you on the right. They pass you on the left. They pass you in the breakdown lane. No matter how fast you go, they go faster. And that includes 18-wheelers. It's madness. And I was absolutely exhausted by the time we got to Lauderdale.
Well, and I have to say, like, even if you take the tollway, which is like still has a bunch of
trucks driving
100 miles an hour.
The tollway is filled with trucks.
It's like Groundhog Day. Like, because there's nothing to break up your view. So it's just like...
Yeah, the drive is
white line fever
is long and
it's intense.
You'd think, oh my God, what a beautiful drive from lovely Nashville to scenic Key West, and there are beautiful parts, especially once you get to A1A.
Yeah, the way that we did it, we went like this. If we had gone, that might have been cool.
Yeah, the routing on the tour dates was a little bit of a yo-yo ride too, because they were rescheduled multiple times because of the pandemic. All the shows that we've completed in the last 6 months, since May, June, July, August, it's about 6 months, have been rescheduled and rescheduled. So the routing is a little awkward. But anyway, we did it. We had a great night in Atlanta. Thanks, everybody who came out to Eddie's Attic. It was packed. It was full. We had a really great engineer and a good time. Got home yesterday. And here we are with new songs for y'all. Thanks for hopping on. I'm going to shut up and try one. This one, I'm not going to go with the upbeat one first. I'm going to go with the, I wouldn't call it downbeat, but it's not upbeat. So let's give it a try. Yeah, Eileen, driving in Florida is the worst. South Florida is a battlefield. Once you get up towards the Florida-Georgia line, it becomes a little less... intense, but oh my God, down there, one of the most stressful things is there's crap in the road, like giant tires and sheet metal, and everybody's swerving at 80 miles an hour to get away from it. It's like anyway, we made it, and we made it down, we made it back, no incidents, we did just fine. All right, world premiere. This is a song that I wrote many, many years ago with my friend Beth Nielsen Chapman. And it was going to be on the Trouble in Love record, but it wasn't quite right. There were several songs that I booted off of that record because they didn't fit the theme, or they didn't fit into what I felt was the standard we had set with other songs. I went back to Beth a few weeks ago and said, let's visit this song again, given the pandemic, given what we've been through in the last 2 years, the number of people that we've lost, and let's repurpose this song. And I think we got it. It is completely different than the original meaning, I like it so much better. This one's called It's Dark Enough to See the Stars. At the bottom of my tears, on the backside of my fears, in the center of the pain, I hear my voice call out your name. Days go by, nothing works. Can't believe how much this hurts. I don't know where you are. It's dark enough to see the stars. dark enough to see the stars, dark enough to see the light from an ocean black with grief. In the middle of the night, as I hold on to your love, like those lights from up above, I have drifted out so far. It's dark enough to see the stars. Curse the clock, time is a thief. Every life it measures brief. Every child is born to die, but the soul is born to fly under heaven's canopy. Tiny diamonds, you and me, lightning bugs inside a jar. It's dark enough to see the stars, dark enough to see the stars, dark enough to see the light from an ocean black with grief. In the middle of the night, as I hold on to your love, like those lights from up above, I have drifted out so far. It's dark enough to see the stars. I've been carried out so far. It's dark enough to see the stars.
That's gonna be in a movie.
You think?
Yeah.
Really?
I can hear it.
Here's a secret. I don't know which one of my songs
you never know,
is
right?
The one that people are gonna migrate to. I can kind of tell when it's not right, but it's hard for me to tell when it is right. Does that make sense? Like, I know mm-hmm. in my heart that I've done my best, but I just don't know if it's gonna resonate. And so we shall see.
You know what I've discovered, like, over the past, like, I don't know, I guess a few months, because I put out some singles that I was going to share on Patreon only, and then I decided, well, I'll put these out because it'll be, like, till 2023 till put out a record, and I'm proud of them. What I realized is each one of those songs, like, I knew they weren't going to end up on a record, but I really enjoyed them, pulled in a completely different audience.
Isn't that?
Like, one really pulled in, like, a lot of younger people that are into, like, alternative music and that kind of thing, and the other one did something different. It's like, wow, I wouldn't have known, you know.
Well, I think people find songs when they need them.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
And I think that songwriters write songs when they need them. And it's pairing those two things up.
Mm-hmm.
That is, I think that's what the hope is to match the songwriters need to write what the listeners need to have something articulated. Francesca says that's the title of the record, Dark
that's
Enough to
I
See
said.
The Stars.
That's what, Jane, what I said.
That's what Jamie said. Well, I took it from a sentence that Dr. King wrote, and I believe it was in the letters from a Birmingham jail, though I'm not sure. It's from a Dr. Martin Luther King speech that was and has been quoted many, many times. It's a beautiful thought that in the darkest of times, we figure out what matters. And of course, what matters is love. And what occurred to me when I finished this song in Atlanta in the extra room was that even though my friend, my dear, dear friend, is not with us, I can hold on to her love. I don't have to let go of her love.
No, no way. Yeah.
And that's what I hold on to. And that will bring some comfort in the grief. The love is still in me because she gave it to me. Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
The song helped me to understand it. It helped me with my grief very much. And so the listeners will put their own, like Stephen says, their own movie to the soundtrack. And that's why often it's good to write in metaphor instead of literal, because people's experiences can attach easier if it's not exact literal. It's also, I think, in many ways, more beautiful to write in metaphor. Mm-hmm. But the trick with metaphor, of course, is that if it's all metaphor, nobody knows what the hell you're talking
right.
about. It's got to be grounded. And so we go. Thank you all so much for the positive feedback. I'm reading the comments because I don't know what folks are going to think about these songs. They're brand new. They're little babies just being born. And your positive thoughts are real good. Helps me. Okay, here's another one. This one I find scary. It is a happy song.
Ooh, spooky.
Ooh, happy song.
Spooky Halloween.
A lot of things can go wrong with a happy song.
That's true.
Well, I've played this for you once or twice, huh? Sing the chorus.
Once.
Yeah. Sunrise at low tide, songbirds on the high wire, full moon on the hillside, hanging low, walking round with a big smile. It's been such a long while. How'd you find me? How'd you know? I was shipwrecked, stranded, sidelined on the shore, and you wrapped your arms around me. Now I look for love no more, more. Butterflies, your golden hair in the sunlight, your heart so true, Sailboats on the skyline. Feels so good to feel fine. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No more waiting. No more searching. No more drifting. No more alone. I got my love beside me, and I am finally home.
Awesome.
Kurt Vile.
Yeah. I could hear that, actually. I could also hear Robert Plant doing it.
Robert?
Yeah.
Robert.
So he would slow it down a little bit and do his thing with his, you know.
His hair, his shoulders.
His shoulders, where they go like this. Can't you hear?
Hey, man. Robert, it's all yours, brother man. You want it? You got it.
We have something for you, sir.
Oh, I love Robert. I love Robert very much.
Yeah, this is going to be a radio hit.
You think?
It's such a jam.
Really? Well, that's two for two. We're batting so good. So far, so good. Let's see. A lot of them we have played on the live stream.
Oh, my gosh. I love this. Chris Reynolds says, this song is how I feel about my wife of 40 years. She is my world and keeps me stable in this fall apart world. That is beautiful.
Oh, Chris, I'm so happy I wrote your recommitment song. Remarry at 40 years. That's awesome. 40 years is a beautiful thing. And love is a beautiful thing. And we're going to play another new love song. What do you think?
Sure.
Good luck to us.
You're doing this in F, is that right?
I tuned down the other guitar, so. All right, brand new, hot off the press. Bicycle bells on Rembrandt Street, Spanish shoes on a stranger's feet, newsboy caps, old Dutch men, an alley cat with a Cheshire grin, sailors' bars, old cafes, cobblestone carriageways, kisses in the summer rain, falling back in love again. All right. Feeling all right in Amsterdam tonight. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam tonight. Rocking horse carousels, Calliope's cathedral bells, hyacinths, daffodils, tulips on the windowsills. It's been a heartbreak year. I'm so glad to be back here, walking these old streets with you, wide awake, a dream come true. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam tonight. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam, Amsterdam tonight. Chandeliers, marble stairs, windows open to the square, late night coffee, gingerbread, cotton sheets, a king size bed. None of this is gonna last, all of it is gonna pass, but I look into your eyes and see I got everything I'll ever need. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam tonight. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam, Amsterdam tonight. Feeling all right in Amsterdam tonight. All right, feeling all right in Amsterdam, Amsterdam tonight. Amsterdam, or is it, should it be Amsterdam tonight? I don't know.
There are a lot of songs already called Amsterdam. Maybe Amsterdam tonight would be.
Another happy song. That's right. Very, 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 very unusual for me. Happy songs. They're hard to write, and the trick to happy songs, I think, is to be able to express love in a non-cheesy way.
It's so hard.
Yeah.
It's so hard.
Yeah.
Ryan asked, he goes, is this the Amsterdam layover song?
Yeah,
it is. The Amsterdam layover song.
It is exactly that. We got to spend a few days in Amsterdam because our flights got discombobulated leaving Boston to go play in Denmark this summer. And because everything got delayed and we'd have to spend the night in Boston, we said, well, just can you take us instead of to Germany, where we're going to connect to Denmark, can you take us to Amsterdam and then route us from Amsterdam? The answer was yes, and that's what we did. And we got to spend three days in the city of Amsterdam during what was still partial shutdown. And so the tourist the amount of tourists was low, so we could just walk into the restaurants that we wanted to
And the museums. I went to a museum and saw like some stuff from artists that I'd never seen anything before that had been on my like wish list for a long time, and it was mind-blowing.
That's right. You went to the museum and I worked on this song.
Yeah, I went to the MoCo Museum and you.
She went to the MoCo and I wrote the beginning of Amsterdam tonight, or is it Amsterdam? I don't know.
Yeah, that song actually started when we were teaching, or you were teaching at Rocky Mountain Folks Festival.
We got a chorus that we liked the melody. But we didn't like the words, no. So we had to get a flight canceled and go to Amsterdam to find the words. It's funny how these things come together. And this one is something that I wrote with Long Haul Paul and Darden Smith at the beginning of the pandemic in early 2020. We got on the Zoom figured we should give it a try. And it was the very first, I think, song I wrote on Zoom.
Really? Wow.
I think so. It was before I started writing with Ben on Zoom. And we hopped in and we found a lot to write about. Turns out long-haul truckers and troubadours have a lot in common. And so Truckers and Troubadours is the title. And you might have heard it. We've played it a couple times. But I'm going to try to get this one on the record. I like it. So it's a three-way ride. Darden Smith, Long Haul Paul, and Mary Gauthier. See if I can get this right. Truckers and troubadours, black coffee and metaphors, steering wheels, late nights and songs. Wake up in the morning, we're gone. On the stage, on the road, pack it up, pull the load. Thousands of miles left to do, always just passing through. Truckers and troubadours, our other half walking the floor. Can't wait to make it back home. Counting the days till we're gone. Gear jammers, rhymers, not made for these timers. In love with the strange and the new, always just passing through. Headlights and stars in our eyes, packing our bags as we must. Sometimes it's heaven, sometimes it's hell. Slaves to the old wanderlust. Truckers and troubadours, better off not keeping score. White lines, rear view town, too late to turn back now. Dashboards and dials, feeling the miles. Missing old friends we knew, always just passing through. Truckers and troubadours, truckers and troubadours, truckers and
merch idea.
Yeah. Oh, what?
I think a really cool poster that's a Venn diagram of Truckers and Troubadours, and it has like basically all the stuff in the
middle. Characteristic personality
like
types?
The, just the things in the song, like you know how there's actually so much in common, like it would be like pretty much nothing on the I can see it in my head.
Oh, cool. That we're very much the same
exactly.
personality type.
Yeah.
Well, let's go with it.
I'm starting to get. This is why I like the record coming together. I'm like, what can we?
New ideas.
I like the corresponding artwork and.
Yeah, this is kind of exciting now that you come to think of it.
Oh, it's so exciting.
I haven't been excited. I just haven't known. I don't know if.
It's hard to see how it fits together. You think? Because you haven't sat down and.
Well,
like,
because these were written over a long period of time,
mm-hmm.
right? So.
And you helped me with mine because I uploaded all this stuff and you listened to it. Like, we both kind of listened to it over and over again. But you haven't really done that with your own, right?
I have not. No. Not this time for some reason. I used to do that. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. This will be my, I think, 10th record.
10th or 11th, yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. This time it feels like I have maybe a little... It's weird. Is it I have more confidence or that I just feel like I should do this, so I'm going to do it, and it has everything to do with this is what I do more than, oh, my God, a record.
Mm-hmm. That feels like...
This is my job, and I know how to do it, and we're going to do it.
That's how you've approached it.
I think so. A lot of the artists... I have many times gone into a record thinking that it's life or death. Like this is everything
totally.
Rides on these totally. 10 songs.
Do you think some of that has to do, too, with the fact that, like, you're working with the same producer? Because it's been a while since you've done that, right? Worked with the same producer.
Well, I'm certainly comfortable with Nielsen Hubbard.
Yeah.
And I know he is going to do the songs right. And so I can just lean in knowing what to expect there, so I'm not nervous.
Maybe there's
a familiarity. Yeah, and I also know everything doesn't ride on these 10 songs. That I'll make this record and I'll make another record and I'll keep making other records until I can't, make records anymore, which is going to mean that either something has happened to my mind or my body or I have died. I mean, I'm going to make records in perpetuity and no one record is do or die. You want to do your best every time, of course. You want to have people love it every time, of course. But I don't have that sensation of this is the most important thing in the world.
Mm-hmm.
It really is not. The most important thing in the world is love. And this is an expression of love, but it is not the only expression of love. And so I guess maybe... Also, I'm having, a birthday in March, and there may be a little maturing happening. I have a big birthday in March, and I was born March 11, 1962. So if you do the math, you will quickly find out I turned 60 in March. And maybe there's, my friend Susan always said, as you get older, it's harder and harder to find big deals. Like,
oh, that's great.
That the
that
big deal
is
thing
great.
Is like, it has to be a big, big deal to be a big deal. Like a big deal is,
I can't wait for that.
Is maybe a health crisis or there's in day to day life less and less big deals, and sense that we're gonna just see it through and make our way to the other side of whatever's in front of us as best we can without the drama of the big deal-a-thon.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the good things about getting older, I think. It's I hope. I feel that. Maybe that's part of why it's kind of like, I'll go on and make a record.
This is so interesting to me to, like, hear.
It's interesting to talk. We never talk like this.
We don't. And
When you turn the camera on, we have a different conversation.
Well, because I don't know. I feel like I like asking. I don't know. It's like as a... an artist that's newer, especially to making records, I haven't really been through that process very often. So it's like really fascinating to me. And it's fascinating to me because I feel like I'm experiencing it in real time. Like I heard you write a lot of these songs, or I heard, you know, the revisions of a lot of these songs. And so this is really the first time I'm really seeing it come together too. And it's exciting to me. And it's been interesting to watch your approach to this record, because I do feel like it is unique
chill.
For all the reasons you stated. Yeah.
Yeah, pretty chill.
I can't, I don't know what that's like, to be really chill around that process. I'm not. I'm not there.
I don't either. This is my first time to be really chill around this process.
Yeah, and it's cool to see that, you know, after it took 11 records. So.
It takes a while.
Thank you for letting me ask you all these questions.
You're so welcome. You're so welcome. I think that it's a normal thing to think that your life depends on this record in the beginning. And then you realize that, no, your life depends on your heartbeat.
Mm-hmm.
The do or die sense of this is everything. I remember for my first major label record, mm-hmm. I really had the do or die thing. Like, this is my chance. I have to make it. When I was on Universal, like, this is the one. This is your shot. Everything's riding on this. And I did everything I could in my power to not upset the label or upset the apple cart or comply and play the game the way that they were laying it out. And I got a manager named Mark Rothbaum, who managed Willie Nelson. And Mark came in at the middle of the Mercy Now record release and managed me. And much to my good fortune, he put me on the road with Willie, and I got to open a bunch of shows for Willie Nelson. And when I got all tiptoey around the record company, Mark was very, very quick to say, "What? Calm down. They're just a record company. You're going to do dozens of records.
Record deals.
Records and record deals."
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, oh, God, I never thought of it that way, and it doesn't feel possible or true. Please don't upset them. He's like, it's just a record company, Mary. It's just this. You're overthinking this. Let's get you what you need. Like, dang, good to have him on board for that.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you feel a pressure ever starting at 40? Like, do you think that's another thing you went into? The deal of you getting a record deal is different than like a 22-year-old kid getting a record deal, right?
That's
You're
true.
Like, yeah, Mark, but how many record deals do they give to
40-year-old lesbians?
40-year-old lesbians in Nashville.
I know.
Exactly.
Of one.
You know, like, I could see why maybe for reasons he didn't understand. Although, I mean,
No,
because
he was
rested
right.
on your and he was right, yeah. And
he was right.
And like, you're a one in a lifetime type of artist, you know, so of course you're gonna have opportunities for your songs to be heard. But
thank you.
But
honey.
I could see how, like, you would think, you know, being in that position, like, first, it's like kind of, it is a miracle in one way, right?
Oh,
but at the same time, like, the work merited, like, you put the work in, and the songs were supposed to be heard, I think, in that powerful way. Those songs were so kind of destined to be shared with a large audience.
Maybe.
And Universal helped you do that, right?
Yeah, maybe.
Am I overthinking it now?
I don't know.
Sorry, I've been talking for
a while. You know, I was really intimidated by being on a major label, and I didn't want to upset anybody at the label and get myself dropped. But, of course, I got myself dropped because that's how it goes. And mm-hmm. actually, I didn't get myself dropped. The label folded, you know, because labels fold. And so they closed the doors to Lost Highway. And I'm like, damn, that was my one chance to demand a bus. And I didn't do it.
Oh, because you didn't want to upset the record label. Mm-hmm. Somebody else was giving that advice to. Is it Bonnie Hayes, the songwriter?
Get everything you can while you can.
Exactly. She was giving that advice to younger songwriters. Yeah, if you've got a major deal, make them.
Go get the money.
Yeah
get
don't,
the bus.
Don't feel weird about not being, you know, spending all their money. She's like, spend all their money because they're going to drop you.
They're going to drop you. Or they're going to fold. And the business model is such
exactly.
a mess. Yeah.
Sorry.
Highway 90 westbound in the falling dark. I'm rolling past cornfields, catfish farms and swamps. A Pascagoula sunset, longing breaking through. Don't know why I'm always leaving. I don't know why I left you. Won't you meet me in the meadow? We can look up at the stars, lean into the wind, dream again. Find out who we are. Won't you meet me in the meadow? No more alone. We could lay down in the grass till the feelings pass, then go on. So much to tell you, I am ready to come clean. I'm so tired of running from things I cannot leave. You and me and Mississippi battled beautiful scars in need of forgiveness and the grace of God. Won't you meet me in the meadow? We can look up at the stars, lean into the wind, dream again, find out who we are. Won't you meet me in the meadow? No more alone. We could lay down in the grass till the feelings pass, then go home. Throw a blanket in the grass till the feelings pass, then go home. I wonder what that's going to sound like with the band.
You know who I could hear singing on that?
Who?
Allison Moore.
Then let's do it.
I'm getting all these ideas.
Allison Moore, consider yourself invited.
I mean, she can sing on anything.
She can sing on everything. I talked to her this morning. She said she's around and don't hesitate to call.
All right, love that.
So the two of you on that song, that would be tremendous. We're getting ideas, ladies and gentlemen. So this is sort of a behind-the-scenes look at making a record. We might even hit a live button while we're in the process over there and let people see what we're doing for a little bit. I did that with the Veterans record. We had the band playing and brought people in the studio with an iPhone when we were cutting Bullet Holes in the Sky song.
Wow.
So they could hear the process and see it. We, honest to God, just make this up. It is very much manifestation of imagination. We imagine it and then we manifest it. And so we don't have a big plan. I think in many ways, big pop records are very plotted out. But with a record like us, like what we make, we're gonna build it little by slow in the studio and figure out who might sound good where. And because we're in Nashville, we can call so many incredible pickers, players, singers to become part of our process.
And maybe even a friend from L.A.?
Who that?
You know what I'm thinking about?
No.
Greg Lease.
Oh, Greg Lease.
I was thinking about Greg
Lease.
Oh,
yeah, Greg Lease. He's been on the road with...
Jackson Brown.
Jackson. Yeah, yeah. I was texting with Greg. He said he'd be willing. He can play everything. God, he's the best.
I know, he's so good. I know. Okay, I'll stop coming over there. I'll try to stop coming over
there. Yeah, well, we've got ideas. We got an embarrassment of riches.
You know what's cool about a producer, too, is like how... I mean, there are always surprises for sure, but there are some things that they can hear that... Like, they can hear into the future. We were like, what are they doing? How do you think that's going to work? And then you fast forward three steps, and it's like, whoa, my brain never would have put these elements together.
Right,
like, it's
right.
Such a powerful...
They know how to lay down the basics skill. And then build it, so they can kind of hear three steps in advance.
You have to, I think.
Yeah, you have to. You absolutely have to. It's a chess game. Michele, we will be sending tracks to Italy. The travel has been so discombobulated. The back and forth has been so hard. And he's got his visa. But now this new variant making everything hard to know if he can get here or get back. We will send tracks to where he is. And he will definitely lay down some fiddle on this record. No doubt about it. He's part of the process. All right. Let's see. Leslie Mendelson. Yeah.
Yeah.
She Leslie. Was at the show that mm-hmm. we went to. She was tremendous, Amy. We saw her with Jackson.
Everybody gets along.
In Albuquerque. Yeah. Mm-hmm. At the show in Albuquerque. Yeah. All right. This one is maybe the one we play the most. Written with Caleb Elliott and the great Peter Case. Crescent City disappearing in the rearview mirror, just like she's always done. Spend my life running from the ghost of the Vukari and that dirty spillway water in the noonday sun. The daughters of charity left a mark on me, keeping secrets well, it just makes you feel alone. Magazine Street stole from me, and I never thought I'd find my way home. Thank God for you, I thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. Junkie jonesing on a Greyhound bus with a 20-year ticket to a tortured mind. Sirens, sorrow, cigarette butts. My Jesus in pieces, broken as a highway lines. I thank God for you. I thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. You gave me something no one can take away. You saw through me, girl, but you love me anyway. Thank God for you. Thank God for you. Wake up in the morning, I thank God for you. Thank God for you. I thank God for you.
Sweating.
You sweating?
Sweating.
Yeah, we're not cold anymore. The house was cold when we got back from Atlanta. Well, from Key West via Atlanta. It got chilly here a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Let me read a quick thing. I want to thank everybody who's bought my book. Really appreciate it. Show and tell time. We're sending them out signed from my website. Let's see how it goes. I can't see it. Hopefully you can. The light is too bright for me to see it. We're sending them out signed right now for the holidays. And if you want to get one for a gift or something, I'm happy to sign it. We've been selling quite a bit of them on the road after the show. And it's been a process carrying these books. They weigh 1 pound a piece, hardcover. If you sell 25, 30 a night in a 5-show run, that's 150 pounds that I have to drag.
That's luckily, I'm getting tough.
Jamie's got a trainer. We got nothing to worry about over here.
I'm carrying those books up stairs, juggling them.
She carried 2 heavy suitcases all the way up to Eddie's. That's a lot of steps. There's no elevator, and there's a climb. You carried all those suitcases.
That gave me some self-esteem at once.
I was scared. I don't know. I couldn't believe you did it. I was like mortified. I was scared that you'd trip up or fall. I mean, they could throw you out of balance quite easily. But she did it. Jamie Harris, strong woman. Working out with the trainer for a year now, and she's getting muscly. And she likes to use them.
Now, what's the point of having them if you can't carry them?
Do it. So, this is an instruction about writing I believe I got this from John Lennon. I write a whole chapter about his song, Mother. And I really, really internalized that song. John was extremely vulnerable in that song. And it was on his first record after the Beatles broke up. And he really goes down deep. He learned this primal scream therapy from a therapist named Janoff, and he let it rip in this song, trying to heal, of course, trying to work through what happened when he was a boy. and little person inside him, all just ripped. And what I got from that song, because that song for me gave me permission to write this record I wrote a bunch of years ago called The Foundling, which is my own inner child stuff. And the book helped me to see that John Lennon's song Mother was the permission I needed to do that. And so on reflecting on John and that song, here's what I wrote. John Lennon's mother came to me like a message in a bottle 30 years after John recorded it. And here's what the message was to me. Tell your story real. Tell your story true. Be courageous. Do not worry about who you will scare or who you will offend or if it will sell. Do this for your own soul. Do it for your own salvation. Do it because you're called to do it. You cannot be loved if you cannot be seen and heard. And you cannot be seen and heard if you can't articulate what's inside you. Do it for love. Do it for love of self. Do it for love of life.
Mm. That's incredible.
Thank you. You know what I want? I want to hear a Jamie Harris song.
Okay.
Would you lay one or two? Lay two down.
Ooh, okay. Well, can I try something real quick?
Try anything. Jamie, you've been doing so great on the road.
Well, thank you.
I've been listening to you night after night, and it continues to inspire me. You've been playing cover songs, too.
I have been.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe I'll do a cover song, too. That'd
yeah.
be fun.
Boy, Jamie's been singing Florida, a Patty Griffin song. Mm-hmm. To great fanfare. People love it, and I love it, so that's important.
That's important.
So, yes, you got a new something, or what you got?
Well, that's what I was going to do. I was so inspired by you playing all these new songs that I thought maybe I would play something that I've never played in front of other people.
Okay.
Before. Is that, are you? Should I not do that?
Do it.
All right. But I need words because it's been a while since I played. This ended up being one of the favorites on my record. Mark Hallman plays accordion on it. It's beautiful.
Good morning, my love. Can you hear the birds sing? Hunger now for freedom. 'cause you're just not sure yet which way your heart will turn. Well, I light up hard to kill the pine, most 'cause I like to watch things burn.
Thank you.
I love that song.
Thank you. Yeah, that's one I think I played it in a different, it was one of those that like wasn't quite right, and I played it in a different formation in front of people once. So that this is the only other time I've ever done it. And I think, like, it's funny you're talking about Patty. I think that's probably melodically the most Patty Griffin inspired thing I have.
Yeah, like I Drink is my most John Prine inspired
totally.
Thing.
Totally. Exactly.
That's your Patty thing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Gorgeous. Love that song.
Want to play one more?
Mm-hmm.
Well, speaking of, like, influence-inspired song, I did a, over on my Patreon, I was thinking about, like, you know, winter songs, and I'm kind of, like, not a big, like, Christmas song person, but I do always think of Snowin' on Raton around this time and some other songs that kind of have, like,
wintry. Snow, yeah.
Yeah, snow and like...
Seasonal
songs, exactly. So I put a little cover of Snowin' on Raton up there, and it reminded me that I think, you know, I'm a huge Towns fan, obviously, and I think that this song is the most directly inspired by Towns. So this one. I guess I'm feeling mellow today.
Mellow's cool.
Tonight the moon is colored black, old smoker's teeth. I know it sounds crazy, but it almost seems in reach. Kinda like it. Song. haunts me, that the ghost ever ever left unknown. They keep quiet as the morning breaks the cold. I won't think about it as I travel down this road, kind of like it is.
Call that a LaFave ending there.
It's very, very beautiful.
Thank you.
Makes me think of the desert. Did you write that in Terlingua?
I wrote part of it. It started in Terlingua. Yeah, the first verse is, well, this, the first verse I wrote is the second verse. I wrote that in Terlingua. And then the second verse I wrote is the last, or the last verse is the second I wrote. I wrote it coming out of Telluride when I got stuck on a mountain. Which is, I realized as I was recounting the story on Patreon that that was when I briefly met you. You were running to the merch table, and I was late. I missed your whole show because I was coming in to Telluride to see my friend Sam Baker.
Who I was playing with.
Exactly, but I missed you because I got stuck. There was a mudslide, so no one could come in on the mountain. And
avalanche.
Yeah, it was weird. So, yeah, so, and then the first verse I wrote last, outside of Amarillo. I wrote a lot of it traveling.
Outside of Amarillo. Outside of Amarillo. Jeez, that's the first line of something.
Well, actually, that's an Enemy Loose song, you know?
Is it?
Well, yeah. You know?
How's that going?
That's... My baby never was a cheating cat, but it wasn't because the ladies didn't try. Everywhere I go, they're walking around him slow, giving him a flutter and a sigh. I got him past that redhead in Atlanta. Lord, I walked all over that black-eyed Cajun queen. But outside of Amarillo, he found his thrill, I'll tell you. I lost him to a jukebox and a pinball machine. You know that song?
No, but...
I was like, that's the key is way too high. Definitely not C. Sorry about that. But it's a barn burner. That's fun.
It's a dancing song.
Outside of Amarillo, yeah.
That's one of the early records.
Yeah, she wrote that.
Hot band.
She wrote it was Rodney Crowell. Exactly right. Yeah.
Hot band. So I just want to let folks know that we're doing handwritten lyric sheets for the holidays. And I've got a stack of these pieces of art that Darden Smith has painted. And I'm writing lyric over the top of Darden's art. You can request whatever song you want. If it's one of the...
I want that one.
That's very. You want everything. Every poster, every...
I do.
You get to have whatever you want. You know it. And whatever song you want, I'll write it on top of a piece of art that Darden has painted, particularly the soldier songs from the Rifles and Rosary Beads record. Like I said, Darden Smith is the co-founder of Songwriting with Soldiers. And so it's on my website. It's called, I think, Special Lyric Sheets. Or you'll see. It's the collaborative... gift edition of lyric sheets.
Mimi asked, can I request one of the new ones? Yes, any Mary Gauthier
song. Yeah, any song. Yeah, yeah. The brand new songs, good luck with the titles since I don't know what it is, but type in there what you remember and I'll know what you're asking for. What else do we have? We're doing a 3-CD vinyl. I don't have the third one, but the third one is live at Blue Rock. It's a 132 gram double vinyl record. It's super heavy. I have a bunch downstairs. So three vinyls signed. And these are all gift ideas. The special edition Darden Smith Mary Gauthier collaborative lyric sheet, three signed vinyls, and of course the book signed in bundles with lyric sheets and other things. They've come up with some stuff on the website that is new. It's not new. It's combined with stuff for a discount. So this plus that equals a discount somehow. And that is my spiel. As always, Jamie's Patreon is waiting for you to sign up.
Yeah, and that song I just played is on the Patreon as well.
The Emmy Lou song?
Oh, not that one. I should do that. It would be fun.
Oh.
No, the Like You.
Like You.
Yeah, that was the first song. Well, we recorded that when I made the Congress House sessions. I thought it was going to be a bonus track, and you and I were listening to it in the car. I don't know if you remember this moment. And we both kind of, like, without saying, we didn't say anything for a while, and we were like, well, that's not a bonus track. That's the beginning of a new record. And so that's when I called Mark, and we decided to make that record together. And
I do remember that moment.
And we actually ended up using, for the record, we used the original track and just added a little bit of guitar.
Because it was so great. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
So that's how that came about. So, but you can hear the original version with the that was supposed to be on the Congress.
So hop on to Jamie's Patreon through her website. You can, for as little as $3 a month, get access to what she's up to. And she sends folks music and stories and postcards and, of course, new songs and cover songs. Speaking of, we've got time for two more. I told them you might play Florida, and I think they want to hear Florida.
You want me to play Florida?
I want you to play Florida.
Okay.
And then we'll play one more, and then
you
I'll call it. I got to go do a TV interview after this.
I'll play it. You heard it here first. This will actually be on my Patreon tomorrow. It drops tomorrow. Yeah.
Oh.
I made a video of it, and it'll...
Well, there you go. Jamie's made a video of this Patty Griffin song that... I love, and that I think she sings beautifully, Patty and Jamie. So we'll do that, and then we'll do one more, and then I have to run to the interview.
Okay, thanks for asking.
90 minutes is up anyway.
Wow, three songs. What?
A couple young girls went sailing down a moonlight into the arms of Florida, sailing down the highway, singing their heads up, protected by the Holy fighting from the ocean, drive with their eyes closed. You know the man wants to kiss you deep beyond its way. The promises it never intends to keep every day, isn't it hard? Makes promises. his heavy boots on, kicking along the blacktop. Sandwalks of 818, young girls in their bare feet, a cigarette smoking, looking every which way, wishing and a hope.
Song.
Yeah, almost got it. The last verse will be correct, or the last chorus will be correct on the Patreon video that comes out tomorrow.
That was beautiful.
Thank you. I love singing Patty. Oops, sorry. I love singing Patty Griffin songs.
I love hearing you sing Patty Griffin songs. Well, that's us for today. That was 90 very fast
minutes.
Wow.
Yeah.
And we appreciate y'all jumping on the live stream. We'll try to do it again next week. See how tired we are midweek in the studio. I think we'll probably try to do it again next week because we won't be able to do it again for a while after that. We're getting back on the road to see family and stuff for the holidays, going to Texas, and so forth and so on. So when we're gone, we're not going to be able to do it. It's too hard. So probably next week we'll announce it on Facebook and on our Instagram. So stay with us on that. And we have a new member of our team. We want to welcome Amy Pugh to our team. She's got her hand on the socials, taking care of these announcements and so forth for us. So I think that's it for Sunday. Don't forget, we got bundles. Every CD I've ever made, which I believe comes to 11, is $50 on my website. If you want to see what that looks like, I have them right here. This is a real nice Christmas gift, too, for somebody. And we're fixing to add to this pile. After next week, we'll have another one. But this is what it looks like, the entire catalog, which includes the very rare and hard to find Foundling Alone, which is why I add this. This is all acoustic version of the Foundling. Just me.
Wow,
and
I love
my
that.
Voice.
I love it.
You like
I
this
love
one?
That. Yeah, I found myself, as far as the Foundling goes, I think I've listened to that.
People listen to this
more.
One more than the produced one. The produced one I made in Toronto with Michael Timmons, and Margot Timmons sings harmony, and you might know
so
those
awesome.
Names because that's the Cowboy Junkies. This one is just me doing my thing. And the artwork is done by the incredible Gail Merowitz, who just did Ashley Cleveland's book cover and also designed the t-shirt.
Yeah, apparently. Jamie I bought Warren. this t-shirt from this metal band that I like, and then I was looking at Gail's website the other day because her artwork is so beautiful and I love looking at all the records that they've done, and then I saw this on there. I was like, oh, wow, what a small world.
Yeah, Gail Merowitz.
I had no idea.
She's wonderful. I met her through coming to show at Joe's Pub many years ago and walking up at the end of the night saying, I'd like to do your artwork.
Oh, my gosh. And you're like, Oh, you do Amy Mann's artwork?
Like, you work for Amy Mann, but you want to do my work? Okay. And she's also so cool. It's like,
so cool.
If I get to hang with you, you can do my artwork. All right, y'all. We're probably going to be back next week. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for
listening to us talk.
Getting us through this time. I hope we've been helpful to you as well. And till I see you again. Eternity hold you in the hollow of her hand. May a soft wind enfold you as you travel distant lands. May the moon and stars delight you. Daylight dims till the morning sun warms your face, till I see you again. May you lay down your struggle beneath a silver sky. May a summer rain inside your dreams sing a lullaby. May there be no more struggle and no more pain. May you sleep inside the stillness of the night till I see you again. May you never be a stranger. May you never feel alone. May you reunite with family and friends. May they walk you home. May love embrace you in a dance that never ends. May you rest in gentle arms till I see you again. May you rest in gentle arms till I see you. Wish us luck in the studio this week, and we'll be back probably next week, and have a new record in the can when we see you again. Peace out. Take care.
Peace out.
Peace out.